Hello and welcome to Mastering Server-Side Swift using Vapor 3. I will be your instructor, Mohammad Azam. After the success of Vapor 1 and Vapor 2 course, I'm really excited to present to you a completely new course which deals with Vapor 3 framework. Vapor 3 is very different from Vapor 1 and Vapor 2 framework, and it has been written from scratch to accommodate the developers. You will learn a lot about future the asynchronous requests and how they have improved the performance as well as the fluent APIs. So if you're ready, let's check out the contents of the course.
We're going to start the course by explaining what exactly is server-side Swift and how storing information on the device is different than storing information on the cloud. After that, I'll show you that how you can get started with Vapor. We'll go to the vapor.co's website and see all the prerequisites that we need to get the Vapor up and running. This also includes Xcode 9.3 or above, which you can download from the Mac App Store. After you have downloaded all the required prerequisites, we'll be ready to create our first Vapor application. After completing the basic Hello World application, we are going to dive into and learn about Vapor parameters. Parameters in the URL is going to allow us to pass dynamic data right within the URL that can be extracted by the Vapor application. You're also going to learn how you can pass query string parameters using Vapor and easily extract it from the Vapor side. Query strings are going to allow you to pass in the page number, sorting data, or anything you need, and later on extract it on the Vapor side. You're going to learn about the JSON format and how it is a recommended format for interchanging data. And you're going to learn that how Vapor makes it super easy to pass JSON to the users. After that, we will dive into our first application, Nyla's Garden, which will be connected to the SQLite database. We will learn how to interact and perform CRUD operations using Vapor against the SQLite database, which is going to return us different data based on the different routes that are being invoked. We are going to learn good programming practices by creating controllers and groups for our routes. This is going to make sure that all of our routing code is inside the controller, which is going to make it much easier to manage when our application grows in the future. Lastly, I'm going to show you how to create a complete iPhone application called Nyla's Garden, which will be able to add the items to the database, retrieve all the items, filter items, and even delete the items. We are going to use our API that we created earlier for this application.
I really hope that you enjoyed this course. I had so much fun in creating this course. And if you're ready, let's get started.